Okay, good morning. The last class we learned about the history of cloth or how the cloth was being evolved, how it changed from the natural, from nature, the forest, the animal skin, from the leaves, from the bark to a piece of fabric. Okay, now today you will learn about the techniques or process how a cloth is made now in the industries, in the town itself. Okay, so that I told you in last class, cloth are just made up of fibers. There are two kinds, natural and synthetic. In under natural you have cotton, jute, wool, silk. Then under synthetic you will have rayon, polyester, acrylic, etc. Okay, don't worry by seeing all the names, just for your information I am telling you. The cloths are made up of fibers, thin strands, okay, thin strands of thread, which is also called as yarn, that you can either get it from nature, from plants or animals, and or you can make it factories by machines. So from nature itself there are two types, plants and animals. Plants, the cotton you get it from plants, the jute also you can make it from plants, whereas wool and silk are from animals. So the types of cloth which you get from nature, it can be either from plants or animals. But the synthetic, it is artificial, made by humans, or man-made, made by man. And these are the names like rayon, polyester, acrylic, which have different qualities, different texture, different look. Whereas the natural fibers, which is used to make the real cotton, the mostly widely used material in India because of the tropical climate, you get it from plants. Okay, in that cotton plant, the fruit which is plucked to take cotton fibers are called as cotton balls. Okay, so that is from plant origin, that is from nature. Then you know woolen cloth, the sweater, the muffler, the shawls, everything you use, you get it from wool, which is taken from the sheep, the fur of sheep is converted into wool. Then the silk from the cocoon of a silkworm. So these are things that you get from nature, either from plants or animals, natural fibers which are used to make cloth. And there are different techniques I told you that you will learn in this lesson. We will go to that. So make sure you just understand there are two kinds of fibers, natural and synthetic. Natural, that is from nature, and synthetic, that is from man-made or artificial, it is done inside a factory. That also I will erase because you are going to learn the process. So, I told you get fibers, either from nature or it is man-made. Then after getting the fiber, imagine you have got the cotton balls, the fruit, where there will be a lot of fibers. I will just send you pic images later. Okay, and that fibers will be taken and converted into yarn by the process called as spinning. So fibers into yarn or thin threads is done by the process called as spinning. So spinning is the process from where the fibers are extracted, the fibers are taken and converted into yarn, which can be used for making cloth later, and that process is called as spinning. So I told you if it is cotton, it is from cotton ball, the fruit of the cotton balls, which will be white, fluffy, almost like a white small clouds on the garden. And that fibers will be taken up, will be spun using a spinning machine, or it can be done with the hand also, hand machine also, like patli, and that is converted into yarn or thin thread, which is used to make cloth. Okay, so now you have your yarn or thread. You have your yarn or thread, and this from thread to cloth you can do either or knitting. So there are two techniques or two methods or two process to convert a yarn into cloth, a yarn into fabric, a piece of cloth which can be used to do dressmaking. And that conversion are of two kinds: weaving, weaving cloth, and knitting. Okay, now imagine you are doing weaving. Mostly again it can be done by the charkha, or actually charkha is used to spin also. Okay, then later it will be converted into a hand loom. I think you all must have heard the word hand loom. So loom means a machine. Loom is a machine where they bring two separate strands. So two strands are put inside this loom to convert it into a cloth. Okay, so two strands are brought up, are crossed, or kept together in a crossway pattern, and you can weave cloth. Same way you can do with the paper also. In your home you can do the weaving using colored papers, and you can weave a mat, piece of paper using paper. You can weave using strips of cloth which you have used already. So that two strands will be used inside a machine called as loom. Anganeyana hand loom nu varana pattu cotton sarees alla mostly hand loom. Your grandparents will be wearing a major of their wardrobe or the cloth will be hand looms. Okay, so that is using a machine where two strands are joined or combined or crossed one over the other to make a cloth. So weaving is one method or one process where you can convert the yarn or thread into cloth. The next one is knitting. Spelling, it starts with K, but that K alphabet is silent. Okay, when we pronounce, we just say knitting. K is silent, but when you write it, you have to write the correct spelling. So knitting, what you do, mostly woolen cloths are termed with that. You can use other materials also, but generally for knitting you use woolen. Here it is a single yarn. Here it is two strands or yarn. Okay, so weaving, two strands are used inside a machine called as loom to convert it into a cloth. Whereas in knitting, single thread or a single yarn is used to make a piece of cloth. You have knitting needles. Sometimes your parents may be knowing, mostly in northern India they do, because there is a severity of climate of extreme cold at night. So they use more knitting. But here also people do. Okay, you have to have two needles and single ball of woolen threads. And you can do that using the two needles, and you can knit cloth, you can knit a muffler, you can knit a beanie, a monkey cap, or you can even knit sweaters using hand itself. But it will take more time, and mostly when you buy handmade products it will be costly because more effort, more time and more artistry are there. But when you get it from a loom, from a machine, you can make it around 100 numbers in a single day minimum. Okay, so that's why, but when a person is doing it, will take 2 weeks or months according to the his capacity or ability. So this is how a cloth is made from fibers or thin strands, which is converted into yarn by process or the technique called spinning. And another two methods are used, weaving and knitting. Weaving by using two strands, two separate threads combined to make cloth. Hand loom is one of the type of example for that, and loom is the machine which is used to do that. The next one is knitting. Mostly it is done with woolen threads, and you use knitting needle, or it can be also done in a knitting machine where a single yarn is used to make a cloth. So I hope it is clear about how cloth is made. Okay, the next a small topic under this is about color. Color. Imagine whoever is next to you or whoever is in this world, all are wearing just white or just yellow. How will you look? It will look very odd. It will look very boring. So normally we just say, there is a phrase like, add color to your life. Okay, so anything, like imagine years back, maybe around 30-40 years back, we had only black and white TV. We could watch television and all the characters came in the same type of dress because there were no color channels. and slowly the color TV evolved. Same way, if the dresses also, as the people started making the clothes, they also started coloring it, and that color they made it mostly from nature. At that time, it was from nature. Naturally, they could make or extract colors, and that color is called as dye. Pronunciation is dye, but spelling, please check. It is D-Y-E. It is not D-I-E. So make sure you learn the correct spelling. So dyeing of cloth or coloring of cloth made the cloth industry more colorful and more interesting and more enabling fashion to come up or spring up. So from nature, the people who were starting with the fashion, they could extract colors from nature, again from plants, plant parts, etc. Like from spinach, chira, they could extract the green color, green dye. Then from rose petals, they could take the pink or mauve color. Then from indigo, they could take blue color. From turmeric, they could take yellow. So naturally, the people were able to extract dye or coloring agent and color the clothes, color the fabric. But as again the time passed on, more techniques were evolved and people started making this dye chemically inside factories. So the dye are of the other kind, the chemical dyes which are there available nowadays. But mostly everything that is based on nature is more, you use the word eco-friendly, that is good for your skin, that is good for the nature also. So you can get the fibers from nature, you can get the dyes also from nature, and you can make a complete dress or a cloth exactly pure in nature. Okay, so that's about how the cloth is made, from fibers to yarn. And using the yarn, after spinning, you get two other methods, two other steps, weaving and knitting, and you get a piece of cloth, and that cloth can be made attractive by coloring, use of dyes. Either you can get it from nature, even you can do at home using these ingredients, whether with the leaves or with the fruits. You can try and experiment. And also it is available in industry. The chemical dyes, artificial dyes are there, which can color your clothes and look brighter and colorful. Okay, so that's about the cloth and coloring.